It's time once again for that business show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ, where business becomes show business. Jamie is a leading Tampa Bay real estate agent and featured on the Wall Street Journal's list of top 100 real estate agents in the nation. Jamie invites you to list your home with him today and learn more at tampabayradio.com. Now, live in studio and promoting the entrepreneurial spirit that drives the American economy, your host, Jamie Maloney.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. And I'm sure you know by now, this is a weekday show every weekday morning at 8 a.m. here on 1250 Winds WHNZ. And as always, please help support the show and visit tampabayradio.com. Over there, all shows are available on demand. And also, you'll do see that I sell real estate. So if I can in any way help you buying or selling real estate, I want to be your resource for getting that done. And the best way to get me through that is the contact form over there. And also, if you're looking to sell your home in the Bay Area, we do offer a free home valuation. Just put in your home's information on the sell your home link on the homepage at tampabayradio.com, and we'll get you over a free home valuation. Also, I just want to remind everybody of the upcoming first annual That Business Show Awards Dinner. That's going to be held January 25th at the Center Club at 6 o'clock. Tickets are available on the homepage of tampabayradio.com, and we're going to be giving out a number of different awards to many of the past guests that have been on the program over the last year. So very excited for that. It is open to the public. Limited tickets are available, so you'd like to come out and meet me and some of the many professionals that have been on the program, please get your tickets over there at tampabayradio.com. Tickets only $40. The lovely Stella Giudicelli joins me this morning as co-host. Stella, good morning to you.
Well, good morning. I don't know if it's as lovely today because I just come back from swimming this morning and I think I still have the mark of the goggles. So.
Nice. It's a very wet and rainy day out there. So where have you been, Stella? We haven't seen you over the last week or so. How's business been?
Yes, business has been very good. The year is starting up, so I think people are back onto their projects. And so it's been very busy in real estate. People want to buy, people want to sell. I'm actually going to be staying on the show just the first half hour. I'm on my way to get a listing on Davis Island, a triplex.
Oh, congratulations.
Very modern and so a very unique piece of real estate. I'm very excited.
Well, thank you for stopping by the show as always.
You're welcome.
A little morning swim, stop by, do a little co-hosting on a radio show, and then off to a listing appointment. Stella Giudicelli, Feli Realtor at a Coldwell Banker, a great
Life
supporter.
Is good.
Great supporter of the show. Well, we got a great guest online right now. Let me go ahead and bring him in. Nick Friedman is president and co-founder of College Hunks Hauling Junk and College Hunks Moving. Starting alongside childhood friend Omar Solomon in college with nothing more than a beat-up cargo van, today they've grown the franchise to over 50 locations nationwide. He has since been named among the top 30 entrepreneurs in America under 30 by Inc. magazine. Nick, welcome to the program today.
Hey, thanks for having me, guys. And Stella, good to talk to you again. I've actually met Stella in the past.
Yeah, she said she did know you, so good to know that Stella's a supporter of your business.
Yes, it's actually a good story, Nick, right?
Yeah, you got a Nick. And Nick, you're all a local company here with a tremendous story. So I'll let you go ahead and share the story because this is the most exciting part, I think, of this business. Tell us the story of how this got started.
Yeah, so, you know, like most kids, I was brought up to just kind of follow the traditional career path. Get a good job when you graduate, get a good degree when you graduate from high school, get a good job after college. And, you know, that just wasn't for me. It wasn't fulfilling. And the summer before our senior year of college, we actually borrowed my buddy's mom's cargo van from her furniture store, and we just put on computer printout flyers the name College Hunks Hauling Junk. We thought it was a catchy way to make the phone ring. And, you know, sure enough, we did a lot of business that summer. We recognized that people had a need for the service, and they really appreciated good quality image and experience when it comes to customer service. So we ended up writing a business plan our senior year, and it won an entrepreneurship competition. So that gave us a little more confidence in the idea, and we graduated and decided to make the business a full-time venture. And, you know, at that point, we wanted to be more than just a couple local guys driving around in a van. We wanted to be a very successful brand recognized for customer service, great culture, great service, and so we've now since expanded through franchising to over, as you mentioned, 50 locations across the country, and we're headquartered right here in Tampa, Florida, with a national call center based in Ybor. So basically what we do is we help people get rid of unwanted items. We haul away their junk or their donatables and take it to be recycled or donated, and then we also, of course, provide now full-service local moving, which certainly, translates to your profession in the real estate industry. you know, packing up and moving people across town or across state.
Nick, do you remember the moment when you had the idea? What happened? How did you come up with this?
We were sitting around the living room table, and we were just thinking about, you know, what are we going to do this summer to keep ourselves busy? Our parents were like, you're not going to the pool all summer. You got to do something productive. And, you know, we couldn't really stomach the idea of a desk job at that time. Mm-hmm. And my best friend from high school, like I said, his mom had this beat-up cargo van. She said, well, why don't you guys take the cargo van and do some odd jobs? And we were sort of sitting around the table thinking of, you know, well, what could we do? And, you know, we were in college. Obviously, we thought we were, you know, I guess good-looking at the time. So we were like, well, what about college hunks? You know, what about college hunks hauling junk? And we all kind of burst out laughing at first and then sort of paused for a second. We're like, well, that kind of has a nice ring to it. And so that's how we started. And then once I realized how much people needed the service, that's really when the light bulb went off for me, was that this could be more than just a summer gig. We could employ, you know, collegiate-friendly individuals, you know, from all the different schools around the area to provide this service to people that that need it. So it was sort of an evolution, but the idea started out just really out of, you know, the need to keep ourselves busy that summer.
And do you remember your first client?
I do remember our first client. Actually, it was raining just like it is this morning.
Okay.
And we drove out to do this job, and they, I think at the time we were really just advertising on Craigslist and computer printout flyers. And the lady had a old sleeper sofa that she wanted hauled away, as well as a bunch of debris in her backyard. And I remember, you know, when we got down to start lifting the stuff up, I looked at my buddy, who's my business partner now, Omar Solomon, and, you know, the rain is coming down, and I looked at him, I was like, are we really about to do this? You know, is this really what we're going to be doing? And, you know, kind of like that point of like, well, do we put the sofa back down and just go home and play our video games, or do we actually, you know, do the job? And, you know, she wrote us a check for, I think, you know, 150 or 200 bucks. And
very cool.
We still saved that check because, you know, it was like, we were like, wow, okay, people really are paying for this. And she appreciated the work as well. And so we, you know, we said we were all in.
When you showed up, was she in her lingerie nightgown?
You got one of those erotic stories to share with us?
People always ask about the hunks, you know, in the name. And since we've started it, we've tried to sort of, you know, redefine the word hunks. We actually made it an acronym. We say HUNKS stands for Honest, Uniformed, Nice, Knowledgeable Service. So it's more than just brawn and looks. It's about sort of the overall, you know, friendly customer experience. You know, we want our customers to trust us. We want us to know that they care about the guys that are, you know, that the guys that are coming into the home care about the customer's belongings when we're moving their items. And so, you know, some people always joke, hey, do they take their shirts off when they're hauling? You know, what's with the hunk name? How do you hire your guys? But really, it's all about a friendly, collegiate image. So no lingerie was involved in that job.
What about cougar repellent spray? Is that part of your uniform?
No, it's not necessary. Although, you know, it's funny that the name does appeal to the female demographic because, you know, 90% of the time, and you guys probably see this in real estate, the female is the household decision maker. You know, she wants to make sure that whoever's coming to do the work is somebody that she can trust and that is going to do a good, reliable job because, you know, many times it may be, you know, when she's not even home or maybe the kids are in the house. So whoever, you know, anytime you have a service company coming to do work at the house, whether it's, you know, moving or landscaping or anything else, you're really letting a complete stranger onto your property. So you really need to know, you know, who's going to be doing the work. And so no cougar repellent needed.
Now, Nick, I got to say, I mean, this company embodies the power of branding to the team. I've dealt with so many people in the trash out business through the years. I sell bank-owned properties. I've done, you know, hundreds or probably thousands of different trash out jobs, or I've hired many different vendors. And, I mean, to take a trash out company and create a brand behind it, I mean, speaks kudos to your ability as an entrepreneur.
Yeah, you know, branding is really critical in any business, but, you know, our business is very competitive because it doesn't take much to be in the moving and hauling business. All you really need is a truck, maybe a logo and a website or a business card. So we really tried to do whatever we could to stand out from all the other companies. And obviously the name is one thing that stands out. The colors are bright. Orange and green really stands out. And you know, it's all about branding. We've done a lot of, you know, kind of creative things with publicity. We've been on reality TV shows. And so, you know, anything we can do to sort of stand out from the crowd is really important to us. We read a book early on when we started the business called The Purple Cow by Seth Godin. And in that book, he says, you know, if you're driving down a country road and you see a bunch of brown cows, you keep driving. But imagine if there was a purple cow in that field. That's pretty remarkable. You would pull over, you know, take pictures of it, put it on social media. And so that's really what we're trying to do is sort of stand out in a crowded landscape, not only from a branding perspective, but, you know, the brand is what has to sizzle and capture people's attention. But then ultimately, you know, they're going to have certain service expectations. So the service has to be top notch. The customers have to be happy and overly impressed with the service they receive if they're going to be telling people about it, you know, writing online reviews, sharing it on social media. So it definitely starts with the brand, but then the next step beneath that layer has got to be a quality service.
And you're also on Shark Tank. Were you pitching the College Hunks? But I'm kind of remembering, wasn't the College Foxes hauling boxes?
Yeah, so, you know, it's funny. We were actually on the very first episode of the very first season of Shark Tank. So when we went on, we actually didn't even know what the show was. We had responded to an ad in Inc. magazine that said they were looking for entrepreneurs to pitch a business idea for a TV show. And at the time, we had just started franchising College Hunks Hauling Junk. And so we thought, well, you know, this might be a great idea to get the business on national television, to get some franchise inquiries. But we didn't really need investment or want investment for our core business. And so we kind of kicked around, well, what else could we pitch? And we came up with a sister company. We were going to call it College Foxes Packing Boxes. The idea would be that the ladies would do the packing, and then the hunks would come in and do the moving. And actually, one of the sharks, Robert Herjavec, made us an offer, but he wanted equity in College Hunks Hauling Junk. So we ended up turning down the deal, and we never launched College Foxes. And it actually, I don't think, would have worked because of the reason I told you earlier about the women being the household decision makers. They didn't, you know, I think there was more eyebrows raised when it came to the College Foxes idea than the hunks. So we ended up leaving that business idea on the shelf, but it was a really cool experience. Obviously, you know, great publicity, and they still rerun that episode on CNBC quite regularly. So it doesn't hurt on a branding perspective either.
Absolutely, I got to take a quick break. Currently talking to Nick Friedman, co-founder and president of College Hunks Hauling Junk. Learn more about them, collegehunkshaulingjunk.com. You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
Have you considered a reverse mortgage as part of your retirement financial plan? For homeowners age 62 or older, a reverse mortgage from Access Reverse Mortgage is a safe, economical way to turn your home's equity into cash or monthly income. Access Reverse Mortgage is a family-owned company based right here in the Tampa Bay area for the past 10 years. They are A-plus rated by the Better Business Bureau and Florida's leading reverse mortgage provider. Call 727-347-0305 or go to accessreverse.com to start your research today. NMLS number 4566. That's 727-347-0305. Tampa Bay weather is a roof killer. That's why when getting your roof done, you want it done right. Hi, I'm Jamie Maloney of That Business Show. When considering a new roof or repair, talk to Westfall Roofing. They've been installing high-quality roofs in Tampa Bay for over 25 years. Get a free, no-obligation estimate by calling 855-99-ROOFING. That's 855-99-ROOFING. Find out what already 15,000 satisfied customers already know. Call now, 855-99-ROOFING.
Are you in need of new flooring or ready to tackle that home remodeling project? Then contact Yeager & Company Incorporated, a family-owned, state-certified general contracting business with over 70 years of experience and the recipient of the Angie's List Super Service Award for the last 8 years in multiple categories. Yeager & Company comes to you with their shop-at-home flooring sales service, and their hardwood flooring refinishing is the very best in the Bay. Kitchen and bath design featuring American-made well-born cabinets, and all work is done by employees, not subcontractors. Learn more at JaegerFlooring.com.
Are you looking for a local real estate firm that knows the market and has your interests in mind? Then contact Jim McPeak at McPeak Real Estate Firm, a family-owned business whose agents have over 60-plus years of experience in the Tampa Bay market. Many of the agents are military veterans that know the VA process for buying a home and are proud to help our military members in any way they can. From residential to commercial real estate, McPeak Real Estate Firm is here to help. Contact Jim at 813-495-3875 and learn more at McPeakTeam.com.
If you've been following That Business Show on Facebook and Twitter, you may have noticed the quality of some of our images. That's because one of our sponsors is pro photographer Rick Taseda, a member of the Professional Photographers of America. You can view his extensive work by going to his website at ricktaceda.com or call him for an appointment to chat about your photography needs at 813-641-4757. That's 813-641-4757. Rick Taceda Visuals. Call him for your next event or project. In an age when the good and the better vie for attention, it is the best that stands out. The Best of Tampa Bay from Proudly Florida is the love story for the city of Tampa, celebrating success, sharing achievements, a tribute to enterprise and community spirit. Let Proudly Florida showcase your business to your city, your nation, and the world. For more information, email info@proudlyflorida.com and be sure to visit proudlyflorida.com.
Have you ever tried to buy a home for your family only to find out that you don't qualify for a mortgage loan? You thought that after 20 years as a customer of your bank, they would help you when you needed it the most, right? Unfortunately, the banks of today are not the banks of our parents and grandparents, and our relationships with them just don't matter anymore. My name is Frank Cotto, and I'm the president of the Lincoln Lending Group. We all may need a bank, but we also need a Frank, and that's what I'm here to do for you today. Lincoln Lending Group will waive all of your lending fees, which include your mortgage, application fee, your underwriting fee, processing fees, and any bank points. Just call 813-MORTGAGE. You drop the E, and we'll drop the fee.
From the Bright House Networks Traffic Center.
Eastbound 40 Campbell Causeway jam from the Bayside Bridge and McMullen Booth to about midway across Tampa Bay. That's due to a crash in the left-hand lane. You may want to consider using the Howard Franklin Bridge or Hillsborough Avenue. Also northbound 275 in South St. Petersburg. Crash in the center lane near 26th Avenue South. Eastbound side, the Summit Expressway, very slow into downtown Tampa due to a crash blocking the lane. Southbound 275 jammed from Beers to Hillsboro. See traffic problems, call the injury firm of Abrahamson, New York. Hillsboro traffic tip line, 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by Boys and Girls Club of America.
It's 3 p.m. School's out for America's kids. And when school's out, clubs are in. It's time to support the Boys and Girls Clubs. Visit greatfutures.org.
Today, cloudy with light rain in the morning, then a 20% chance of showers later, high 76. Tonight, mostly cloudy, low 63. Tomorrow, a 50-50 rain chance, high 76.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ. Miss the show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to the program, everybody. You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. And please help support the show by visiting TampaBayRadio.com. Again, all shows available on demand over there. Currently, I talk with Nick Friedman, co-founder and president of College Hunks Hauling Junk. Learn more about him, collegehunkshaulingjunk.com. And Stella, I want to hear a little bit more how you and Nick first met.
Yes, so Nick and I first met in the streets of Tampa, actually. So Nick and his wife. So remember I did that video called Happy Tampa?
Yes.
And so the first time we went in the streets and asked people to dance for us on that tune from Pharrell Williams. And we were actually struggling because we were in Hyde Park and we asked people if they would be on that video that we were doing and we were to play music and they were to dance for us. And people are like, oh, no, we're not doing that. And so as we setting things up and trying to find people, someone in my team comes to me and say, oh, my God, look at this couple over there. They're beautiful. They're walking. They're so in love. And I turn around. I'm like, oh, my God, I have to go and talk to them. So run, absolutely, actually run to them and say, hey, guys. And then that's how we met. So they are at the very beginning of the video.
Is that how you remember it, Nick?
Yeah, it was pretty random. I think we were shopping in Hyde Park. I thought maybe we were in an argument. I don't know if we were that love, but who knows. But Stella came up and said, hey, we're making a video for the Happy Dance by Pharrell Williams for Tampa. You know, can you guys just dance for 30 seconds while we film it and play the music? And so, we obliged. I think I realized she was a realtor, and I said, well, you have to refer us business if we do this dance for you. So I think that's how it worked out.
I guess I was lucky because obviously, you know, with your personality, you're very adventurous and, you know, you make things happen. So you were like our second person agreeing to dance for us, you and Jennifer.
So you just have a natural affinity for the camera and television. I mean, you also were on A Millionaire Matchmaker, too, correct? You were the guy who got the take the girl out on the traditional date, though, correct?
Yeah, so this was back when I was still single, and my business partner and I, after doing Shark Tank, we got invited to go on this dating show on Bravo, and so my day was just a traditional day, but Omar actually picked his date up in the college Hunks hauling junk truck and took her to clean out a garage on national television. And so needless to say, it was not a very good date for him. he still gets a lot of flack for it. But again, you know, another branding opportunity for the company. So I guess it worked out overall.
So I guess you didn't use that trick with Jennifer, did you?
No. you know, my current wife, we did not do any junk hauling or moving as a date.
Yeah, it was. Got to listen to Omar speak at a Tampa Bay Business Owners event a couple of months ago, and he told the story and showed some video of it. And after the trash out, I think the girl was mortified after, you know, having to go on a first date and, you know, get into these, you know, ragged clothing and haul out all this junk from this home, and then to go to a restaurant and the valet has to valet your all's box truck. I mean, it was a hilarious episode.
Yeah, it was must-see TV, that's for sure.
So tell us a little bit more about the franchise now. How do people get involved in, you know, how does this work?
Yeah, so, you know, like any business, when we first started, we were actually doing all the work ourselves. I mean, we were driving the truck, answering the phone, you know, moving the furniture, hauling the junk. I always tell the story, we actually had the 800 number routed to our cell phone, and I would be driving sometimes multitasking and maybe swerving a little bit on the road, and so people would call the 800 number on the back of the truck to complain, and I'd be the one in the driver's seat, you know, answering the phone, apologizing, saying, you know, we don't condone that type of driving in our company. We'll tell those guys to be safer on the road. So we probably fired ourselves 3 or 4 times that first summer. And then we read a book by a guy named Michael Gerber called The E-Myth. And in that book, it talks all about working on the business, not in the business, and being able to create checklists and systems so your business can grow and basically make your business franchisable, even if you're not planning on selling franchises. So that was kind of the first light bulb for us about the whole franchise concept. And we got to work on our business because we figured if we were ever going to have a second truck, let alone a second location, we had to have systems that people could follow and learn and execute to, you know, operate the business as effectively, if not more effectively, than Omar.
How difficult was it making that first franchise sale? Was that a difficult sale because you didn't have, it was just you at that point?
Yeah, it was tough. It was tough. Certainly, I would say probably our first dozen franchise owners was a leap of faith because, you know, unless you're a McDonald's or a Subway, you really don't have the reputation or the track record of success and franchise success. So those early adopters were really critical in our growth. And now, you know, with several years under our belt and several successful franchise owners around the country, we've been able to, you know, make it a viable business opportunity for individuals who want to get into business for themselves, but they don't want to be by themselves and they don't necessarily maybe know how to start something from scratch without the support of training and a call center and you know, marketing support and so forth.
Do you still have franchise opportunities available in the Tampa Bay area, or have you sold them out in this region? And where are you expanding into right now? Where's your growth at?
Great question. So the Tampa Bay area is primarily sold out. We've actually got one opening in Pinellas in spring, but we are servicing that area for the time being. We've got one in North Tampa operating, one in sort of the Brandon, you know, Valrico area, all the way down to Apollo Beach. And of course, we operate the South Tampa operation as well. So the greater Tampa area is pretty sold out. We've actually got over a dozen franchises in the state of Florida, but we are expanding nationwide, and there's always, you know, some franchises that may be up for sale or you know, looking to sell portions of their territory. So, you know, people can get more information at collegehunksfranchise.com if they want to learn, you know, about the franchise opportunity itself.
All right. Well, Nick, a great interview. I greatly appreciate you stopping in, talking to me on That Business Show, and thanks so much for what you've done for the Tampa Bay area. Just a great entrepreneurial story.
No, well, hey, I appreciate what you're doing. Tampa's an awesome entrepreneurial community. It's great to see business owners supporting each other and continuing to grow. So keep up the great work. Thanks for having me.
Thanks, Nick. Take care. And again, that was Nick Friedman, co-founder and president of College Hunks Hauling Junk. Learn more about him, collegehunkshaulingjunk.com. Stay tuned. Coming back from the break, we'll be talking with Dr. Vim Patel and Chitra Patel with Evolve Personal Health. And you're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
Hi, welcome to Yeager's. We just want to take a minute and show you what we're all about. At Yeager's, our primary business is hardwood flooring, although we are remodelers for kitchen, bath, and general construction. We operate a fleet of shop-at-home vans that have all the flooring-type products, hardwood flooring, laminate flooring, tiles, stone, what have you. So we're able to come out first with products in our vehicles and take a look at the setting, how the colors will work, and then to be able to come up with some options and ideas for you. If that's not good enough, we have a large distribution center that we inventory product and have a nice display area.
From the Bright House Network's Traffic Center.
Traffic for the most part slow on all the major roadways around Tampa Bay. Our biggest problems, though, eastbound Courtney Campbell Causeway left lane remains blocked about midway across the bay, and that has traffic slow back into Clearwater. Howard Franklin Bridge may be a better option, but of course, typical delays there. You have slow traffic on the eastbound side of the Selman Expressway from around Bay to Bay into downtown Tampa due to a crash blocking a lane. See traffic problems, call the injury firm of Abrahamson Utrecht Hillsborough Traffic Tip Line, 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by the TampaYMCA.org.
Reaching your fitness goals isn't just a New Year's resolution, it's an all-year resolution. Join your local YMCA today for 50% off in January with a zero sign-up fee. Get started now at TampaYMCA.org. The YMCA, for a better you.
1250 Winds Weather Center forecast. Morning rain should clear out a bit into the afternoon. We'll see a mix of sun and clouds. High today in the mid-70s, low 60s tonight. Mid-70s tomorrow, breezy, rainy conditions once again, and then we'll see the front move through Saturday. Breezy on Sunday, upper 60s, then low 60s to start the week on Monday. Impact Radio, 1250 Winds, WHNZ.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ. Miss the show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business each weekday morning at 8 a.m. here on 1250 Winds WHNZ. And you can learn more about the show over at TampaBayRadio.com. Also, keep in mind, we do stream all these shows here live in studio. So if you're in an office in front of a computer and head over to the TampaBayRadio.com website, you can click on the Watch Live Stream button and see the video in here live each and every morning. And also, keep in mind, we have expanded the show to include a sixth show each and every week. That show called That Business Show, The Real Estate Edition, is where I and my co-host Frank Cotto of the Lincoln Lending Group talk all about real estate, taxes, mortgages, and insurance, pretty much anything and everything related to real estate. Getting back to my roots, because I am a realtor with Coldwell Banker, and so if I can in any way help you buying or selling real estate, please consider me a resource and reach out to me. Best way to get me is through my contact form over at TampaBayRadio.com. Time to bring in my next guests for the program. Dr. Vim Patel is board certified in internal medicine and also a certified personal trainer. His vision is to treat the mind, body, and spirit through the blending of natural medicines and modern science. And he is joined in studio today by Chitra Patel. Welcome to the program today.
Thank you, Jamie. You.
Thanks for having us.
Dr. Patel, I'll start with you. Tell us your background in medicine.
I'm a board-certified trained internal medicine doctor. I've been practicing as a hospitalist for the last decade here in Florida. I trained at the Mount Sinai University System in New York City. We moved down 8 to 9 years ago. It's been a while. We feel like we're Floridians now.
Yeah,
I've been practicing in the Tampa area for 6 years.
Okay. Yeah. Now, Chitra, I'll throw it over to you. You're developing, putting together the concept of Evolve Personal Health. Mm-hmm. What is this?
So Evolve is a completely unique idea in the health space. It's sort of a hybrid model between a concierge medical practice and a wellness program. So we incorporate aspects of coaching and counseling. We assess the body, a person's health through physical, nutritional, and introspective means.
Okay, so this is going to be a physical location, correct? And you're still putting the building together, right?
Yes.
Okay, where is it going to be located?
We are on the corner, or just close to the corner of Manhattan and El Prado.
Okay, and so you're looking to develop kind of a community within the medical practice here. Explain this concept.
So it's a new space. It's a place where patients can come and, I mean, have a completely different experience. Have tea and meditate before they see their doctor.
Okay, so it's not going to be you walk into the doctor and you do your general intake, the blood pressure and weight, and you go in the back. And so you're going to come in and kind of have like maybe a little bit of a holistic experience then. Okay.
Yes.
All right, so describe the experience as I walk in. Okay, some tea, maybe a meditation room. What else?
Well, maybe if we can pull you back to our normal experience of what medicine is today. When we go to our doctor's office, we have a scheduled appointment. Even if you get there 10 minutes early, there's usually a wait.
Yeah.
We're waiting in a very sterile waiting room.
And there's no chance that you can't wait because it's called a waiting room, a classic Jerry
Seinfeld.
Absolutely
correct, Jerry.
Classic Jerry Seinfeld joke. Right. They just prep you for it right there. It's called a waiting room, so there's no chance you're not going to wait.
And you have some magazines which may be a few months old. So then you're after that waiting period, you're taken into a room where you may disrobe, you may not. You're in this paper gown. Likely seated with your bare tush on a cold examining table.
Sounds comfortable to me.
and you wait another 15 to 20 minutes for a doctor to come in who you may not know or who barely knows you. We decided to take a different approach with medicine. And beyond that, I felt the effects of our system practicing medicine for the last decade, both as a practitioner and as a patient. We have the greatest expenditure of healthcare dollars in America and some of the worst outcomes of any industrialized society. So we know that something is broken, and that's clear. There are many efforts to try to change that system in the governmental land, on the financial land. So we decided to look at it from a more patient-centered view. We will build a space which will promote healing. The one thing from the beginning that we realized was of tremendous value was time. So we realize in this hectic world that time is a precious commodity. So we value your time, and we give you an unlimited amount of our time. So when you're a member at Evolve, you don't walk into a space that you feel you have to accommodate to. This is your space. You will feel an absolute comfort. It is a space of healing. When you come in, your course is already charted. Your doctor will be waiting in the room, which will feel as if you're sitting in your living room. We give you unlimited access to the physician, to all your coaches, to all your therapists, at any point in time that you schedule pending, that you feel that you need. So we have organized this around the patient, not around the clinician.
Now, I noticed you used the term a member. So are there going to be other member benefits associated with Evolve?
Absolutely. We envision our members, and we deliberately didn't want to use the term patient because there's so much more to it. We are going to create an interconnectivity between each of our members, and they in turn will create a community. What we want to do is have each member go through our system, and we want to create an intimate picture of each of our members. We've created a unique methodology called the Vimchi method. I think I can have my wife discuss a little bit
that. Explain
that. We have such a great an amalgam of different philosophies, and I think she's
Vimchi. What is this?
So what I started talking about really was the experience, because that's really what people remember. I mean, with when they talk about what they're not happy with in the current healthcare system. And a patient comes in, and they not only have a doctor, but they have a life coach, an introspective counselor, a nutritional counselor, and all this is very personal. So they're creating these personal relationships. And I think that when we talk about healthcare, it's so important for people to not feel alone, because right now, when you're dealing with health, it's almost like you have the burden of whatever your condition is, whatever your health issue is, the pain, the mental anguish about it. And there aren't outlets. There's no other support. And so what we're doing is creating a sort of comprehensive way of where you have all that support.
So it's sort of like this will be like your health team, sort of like mm-hmm. a business professional yes. has his business team, his accountant, his lawyer, his financial advisor. You'll have the
Absolutely.
Different roles within Evolve, correct? Mm-hmm. And life yes. coaching is going to be one of the areas that you're looking to develop. You're a certified life coach, correct?
I am currently completing the course to be certified, yes.
Okay. So tell me again, you come into the facility, you know, what are the different services then that are going to be offered outside of just traditional medicine?
Well, I think that the coaching and counseling is really the main difference. There are so many benefits of being able to walk into a space, speak to someone, be able to come in for, you know, to learn about nutritional demonstrations, to learn about how do you actually cook your food? How do you sort of navigate all of this information that's out there of deciphering between what is healthy, what's unhealthy? Everyone has their unique path.
So it sounds like you're also taking a proactive approach to medicine, not just a reactive where you come in and treat the symptoms, correct?
I think you hit it on the nose. That was one of my adages here. We tend to react when there's a disease state, and that's how we work, and that's how I've been practicing for the last 10 years. We wanted to take a more proactive stance in the delivery of care, not just a reactionary treatment to disease when you break down. And we use the latest technology, and it's been slow to be adopted by some of the clinicians because of the quick advancement of technology. But we're going through a phase that's going to be revolutionary in the next decade. We have technologies coming up, not just in the use of electronic technologies, as well as the biomedical field. We have seen tremendous leaps, something almost analogous to Star Trek when we think about it, but 10 years down the line, that will be commonplace to us. So we want to incorporate a lot of these advancements within our system. We have a specifically derived roadmap, which we'll call it, for each of our clients, where we get to know you intimately. We analyze you through multiple different avenues. We have over 50 different data points that we collect, that we try to get a more refined picture of the individual, therefore giving a more specified and tailored treatment.
I like the type of thinking that you're developing here along the medical system here, because this is what we need in our political system, because we hear so much talk about how to handle, you know, healthcare costs, but you hear nothing about the preventative side of things.
Mm-hmm.
I've said for years, how come we're not hearing more talk about, you know, more physical education classes in
Absolutely.
Schools, more nutritional classes?
Right.
Why do we not hear about tax incentives for businesses to put in wellness facilities? I worked at Cargo, which later became Mosaic, and they had an on-site wellness facility with a person there. And, you know, you were encouraged to go exercise during your break.
Right.
I mean, these businesses should be offered tax incentives for putting these types of facilities in these their businesses, and it would greatly help preventing, you know, these long-term health problems.
Well, we certainly agree with you, Jamie. However, we think that the benefits will trickle down into the greater society at large. When we have a happy, healthy member, client, it then reverberates into greater society and mm-hmm. within their local community as well. So we think simply by giving the individual the chance to be healthy, to be happy, will have a positive impact in not just their life, but in the lives of their greater community, their family, and society as well.
How did the idea come about? How long have you been developing the concept?
I think it came about 2 years ago, and my wife can tell you, I was a practicing hospitalist, and my hours were pretty intense. There would be times that I'd wake up at 5 in the morning, not get back till about midnight, and all the while being on call. And we'd have to repeat this process for days on end, not to mention we'd be on a 24, 36-hour call cycle in between days like this. So I realized that the intensity that I was working at was way too much. And beyond that, we felt the impacts of the limitations, the constraints that were placed on me, not simply by the current system, but by what I can do for the patient. So we decided to kind of remove ourselves from that, to be free of some of these constraints and think patient-centric first. So what impacts, what subtleties, what changes can we make that will benefit the patient to a greater extent? We decided that it was more, we developed a methodology, and if we can get into that, the Vimchi method. It's a hybridization of two words, and it's a hybridization of two philosophies. It also happens to play upon our names. My name is Vim, her name is Chitra, and so we take these two philosophies and we put them together. The Vim is the physical force, it's the vitality that we possess, and the Chi is that life force, it's those interconnections that we can't see. And we really think the value is not so much on the physical side, which I think we have innovative concepts on that end, but we also believe that the Chi side, those interconnections in our lives, our mental state, are very paramount, and these are not addressed in our current system of medicine. Imagine walking into a space and simply feeling happy and at peace. I think that goes a long way towards health.
Well, I definitely, Jamie, like your idea.
They're Jedi.
Another Star Wars reference. Let me take a quick break. Currently in studio with Dr. Vim Patel and Chitra Patel, and you can learn more about them over at Evolve PH. Your website's still under construction, though, right?
They can go. They can put in their email account, and we should have it up and running within the next month.
Okay, so evolveph.com or evolvepersonalhealth.com. You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
Have you considered a reverse mortgage as part of your retirement financial plan? For homeowners age 62 or older, a reverse mortgage from Access Reverse Mortgage is a safe, economical way to turn your home's equity into cash or monthly income. Access Reverse Mortgage is a family-owned company based right here in the Tampa Bay area for the past 10 years. They are A-plus rated by the Better Business Bureau and Florida's leading reverse mortgage provider. Call 727-347-0305 or go to accessreverse.com to start your research today. NMLS number 4566. That's 727-347-0305. Tampa Bay weather is a roof killer. That's why when getting your roof done, you want it done right. Hi, I'm Jamie Maloney of That Business Show. When considering a new roof or repair, talk to Westfall Roofing. They've been installing high-quality roofs in Tampa Bay for over 25 years. Get a free, no-obligation estimate by calling 855-99-ROOFING. That's 855-99-ROOFING. Find out what already 15,000 satisfied customers already know. Call now, 855-99-ROOFING.
Are you in need of new flooring or ready to tackle that home remodeling project? Then contact Yeager & Company Incorporated, a family-owned, state-certified general contracting business with over 70 years of experience and the recipient of the Angie's List Super Service Award for the last 8 years in multiple categories. Yeager & Company comes to you with their shop-at-home flooring sales service, and their hardwood flooring refinishing is the very best in the Bay. Kitchen and bath design featuring American-made, well-worn cabinets, and all work is done by employees, not subcontractors. Learn more at JaegerFlooring.com.
Are you looking for a local real estate firm that knows the market and has your interests in mind? Then contact Jim McPeak at McPeak Real Estate Firm, a family-owned business whose agents have over 60-plus years of experience in the Tampa Bay market. Many of the agents are military veterans that know the VA process for buying a home and are proud to help our military members in any way they can. From residential to commercial real estate, McPeak Real Estate Firm is here to help. Contact Jim at 813-495-3875 and learn more at McPeakTeam.com.
If you've been following That Business Show on Facebook and Twitter, you may have noticed the quality of some of our images. That's because one of our sponsors is pro photographer Rick Tosseda, a member of the Professional Photographers of America. You can view his extensive work by going to his website at ricktosseda.com or call him for an appointment to chat about your photography needs at 813-641-4757. That's 813-641-4757. Rick Tosseda Visuals. Call him for your next event or project. In an age when the good and the better vie for attention, it is the best that stands out. The best of Tampa Bay from proudly Florida is the love story for the city of Tampa, celebrating success, sharing achievements, a tribute to enterprise and community spirit. Let proudly Florida showcase your business to your city, your nation, and the world. For more information, email info@proudlyflorida.com and be sure to visit proudlyflorida.com.
Have you ever tried to buy a home for your family only to find out that you don't qualify for a mortgage loan? You thought that after 20 years as a customer of your bank, they would help you when you needed it the most, right? Unfortunately, the banks of today are not the banks of our parents and grandparents, and our relationships with them just don't matter anymore. My name is Frank Cotto, and I'm the president of the Lincoln Lending Group. We all may need a bank, but we also need a Frank. And that's what I'm here to do for you today. Lincoln Lending Group will waive all of your lending fees, which include your mortgage, application fee, your underwriting fee, processing fees, and any bank points. Just call 813-MORTGAGE. You drop the E, and we'll drop the fee.
From the Bright House Network's Traffic Center.
Crash in the clearing stages on the eastbound side of the Courtney Campbell Causeway. It's about midway across the bay, but traffic is very slow from McMullen Booth. Also, the eastbound side of the Selman Expressway into downtown Tampa, it's very slow from bay to bay due to a crash near the Florida exit. That one blocking a couple lanes. Northbound 75, very slow from 301 towards State Road 60 and southbound 275 from Beers to around Hillsboro. See traffic problems? Call the entry firm of Abrahamson, York, Hillsboro Traffic Tip Line, 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by Lead Safe America. More than 1 in 3 American kids has lead in their blood. No level of lead is safe. Lead poisoning causes learning disabilities and behavioral disorders. Has your child been tested? Learn more at leadsafeamerica.org.
Today, cloudy with light rain in the morning, then a 20% chance of showers later, high 76. Tonight, mostly cloudy, low 63. Tomorrow, a 50-50 rain chance, high 76.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. And again, please help support the show and visit TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Currently in studio with Dr. Vim Patel and his wife, Chitra Patel. And Chitra, tell us a little bit, I mean, how do you see your business evolving in the community?
I think Vim touched upon community a couple of times, and we talk about how community really is the foundation of Evolve. When we create a sense of community, everything else is built after that. And as a business, what we really want to do is promote other businesses and individuals in the area who are like-minded, who do propagate the sense of wellness and health, and looking at it in a little bit of a different way than what we have right now. And so we do plan on being very collaborative and very
non-competitive,
friendly, mm-hmm. and I think inclusive too. I mean, there are so many doctors and specialists and wellness programs and businesses in the area who do believe this, and we kind of have to work together. So we will have events for Tampa, from meditations, nutritional demonstrations, calling other people in to talk, to teach people about anything from juicing to, you know, how do you...
The concept you're talking about here is collaboration. It was one of my New Year's resolutions that I talked with Cheryl Hunter about on the program yesterday. Businesses need to collaborate instead of compete with one another. And so, I love the concept of your business Evolve, because you're evolving as a business. And I'm sure there's probably other businesses, other doctor's offices that have kind of a similar concept, or am I wrong in the Tampa Bay area?
There may be, but it's not a focus. I think that Tampa is in this amazing time where there is this transition. We have, of course, the future of wellness coming to Tampa, and it's sort of setting the precedence of people, of these different wellness businesses, of people changing their mindset. And so I think that it really is the perfect timing for what is going to happen. We're creating that mindset. So when it does come to Tampa, then... you know, people are already more open.
Well, I think it's already happening. I mean, we see what's going on in the downtown district with Jeff Vinnick and making the area more of a live, work, and play environment. So I definitely think it's happening right now. So tell me, how is the business going to work? Is this going to be, are you going to be able to take insurance? Is this going to be cash only? How's membership, I guess, going to work also?
Well, we are a concierge practice, and we do not accept insurance. Simply for the reason, as I spoke about, we had to take it back to a patient-centric idea, and there were a lot of constraints with insurances that we saw. So we decided to just do away with that limitation and having to move forward with whatever impacts we can have on the patient or on our members without these constraints. So we will not be accepting insurance. It will be a membership-based practice.
Are we seeing that move in medicine just, you know, with the results as a result of all the, you know, issues with insurance right now?
Yes, we are. So this is one of the fastest-growing fields in medicine, and medicine, as you know, is still a growing field overall when we look at businesses as an aggregate. And this is one of the areas that is faster, growing faster than even the growth of medicine. But I want to get back and touch upon what you said about Jeff Finnick. So we see vast changes happening as far as medicine is concerned. And Jeff Finnick, owner of the Lightning, is bringing forth this concept of a well district. So our Channelside district is proposed, and I think construction starts this year, 2016, to create dwellings with deliberate intent to improve the health and wellness of its denizens. We also believe that wholeheartedly, but we take it maybe one step further, and we think that a healthier and happier person uplifts their community, creates a positive impact in their environment. We believe that everybody, we can all be better.
Yeah, never mind. He pretty much answered my question.
No,
the question I had was, it was basically, are you trying to make a move to get away from big pharmacy and insurance? Is that the limitations you're? I wanted to know a little bit more about what limitations are you talking about? Because when I go to the doctor, you know, and I need something done, insurance is the big hurdle.
Absolutely.
And also I'm getting more and more into natural medicine. Is that the avenue you guys are traveling down or trying to promote?
Well, we don't restrict any viewpoint, but the limitations that we found practicing within the system were constraints like you spoke about. If you needed to get a medication that was not approved, if you needed to have an x-ray that the insurance company simply wouldn't pay for, however, you're constantly nagging about this knee pain, we were at an impasse.
I mean, the long waits that we experience in the doctor's office is because you're on the back dealing with some type of insurance issue, though, right?
Yeah, that's always something about insurance.
So if you remove insurance from the practice, you'll be able to move people through.
When you walk in, there will be no paperwork to fill out. You simply go to our consultation space, which will feel like your living room, and let's talk.
And that's the other thing that I like hearing, too, is when I go to a doctor's office, it's just a stuffy room with a bunch of sick people, and everything's white, and it's uncomfortable.
Right.
But it sounds like they're coming up with a lounge idea where you go in and you can relax. And a lot of that stress, the anticipation of seeing the doctor, is alleviated. So when you get in there, you're more open-minded and willing and more receptive to care.
Yeah.
And it just sounds like a great idea.
That is very much the idea of when you're open-minded, you are willing to learn about new things. You're willing to be proactive.
Where the location, when is the opening planned?
We're currently under construction. We expect to open spring 2016, so March.
All right, and people can follow the progress over evolvepersonalhealth.com or evolveph.com. Dr. Patel and Chitler Patel, thank you so much for being in studio today.
Thank you, Jamie.
Absolutely. Well, we got to wrap up another great week of That Business Show, and I hope everybody has a great weekend. So be sure to tune me in again Monday morning here at 8 a.m. here on 1250 Winds WHNZ. And in the meantime, check out TampaBayRadio.com for all shows available on demand. You've been listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.